certainly is in a lot of pieces.
Yeah, it is.
What is all this here?
These are parts from two other cars I've parted out.
I gotta have a better look at this.
This car's in a rough state, but it's already had a coat of primer paint, which could save them time.
You tagged all these boxes?
Yeah, I try to tag as much as I can.
Is this bolted down?
No, just lift it right off.
It might not be a bad car to restore, except for one important detail.
Bill, there's no engine here. There's no tranny, no engine, there's no firewall, no heater box.
It comes with a car, but it's not in the car.
A big hole right here, the size of my head.
I've got the metal for that.
I love Mustangs, but that's a lot of work.
It'll be worth it in the end.
Yeah. I'm gonna convince myself on this. Then I got a partner who might want to kill me.
This could be a risky purchase, but Mario's feeling bold.
I'm just gonna sit in it for a minute. Oh, yeah.
The wind blowing through your hair.
Bernie's gonna kill me, but I love it.
Here's your taillight panel.
Yeah, yeah, it's good. So, what are you asking for this again?
I was originally asking six, but I've knocked it down to 5,500.
55, eh? You know what? I want to make you an offer. How about $4,000?
Four's not good, man. It's nowhere near.
What are you talking about? Enough. You're asking 55.
I was originally asking six. I've knocked it down to 55, so I've already compensated a bit.
Now, if the motor and tranny was in the car, I'd say, here, no problem, you know?
Can you do better?
45. 45's top.
Well, I got one more thing I'll show you, okay? And maybe that'll help raise your price a bit. Help seal this deal.
Let me see what you got.
This is called a Marty report.
Mm-hmm.
Marty Auto Works has the database for all Mustangs, and they'll recreate the window sticker, specs on the car, as well as the rarity of the car. And the very final number here is this car is one of one, which makes it rare.
So it was ordered with an electric clock. So because it has an electric clock,
that makes this car unique.
This was the only convertible of this type with an electric clock. Believe it or not, that means for collectors, it's worth more.
I'm gonna make you my last offer. This time I'm walking away. I'll just go to my car and I'm off.
All right.
$5,000 even. That's it.
You got yourself a deal.
$5,000.
Thank you very much.
You're gonna be happy. Just give me that. Thank you.
How you doing, Geezer?
How do you like what I bought?
What have you bought? A piece of top?
Can't you tell what it is? Wait till you see this beauty. It's all here, every single part. Hey, isn't it beautiful? It's already primed. A lot of the work is done.
Did you check all the parts are there?
Well, I didn't count them. Beautiful.
Mario, you never said anything about a convertible.
Convertibles are always worth more money because when the top goes down, the price goes up.
It's not just the fact that it's a convertible that worries Bernie.
You seen this door, though? This door's, like, completely caved.
I know.
It's completely out of line. It's smashed in. And look, it don't even line up with the body. That door is not good, Mario. Have you seen this? That A-pillar looks a bit bent. That can be serious problems.
What are you shaking your head for? It's a beautiful car.
It's a bare shell, Mario. You're looking at bread with no butter. So, you've been through the list. How much do you reckon we're going to get for this car?
Bernie, this car is worth $35,000.
In your dream, son.
I know it. This car is worth $35,000.
Where's the motor? Right. Tell me it's got an engine.
Of course it's got a damn engine. Look.
What the hell is this, man? This ain't an engine. It's a piece of ruddy rust. Look at it. Look at the Ford.
351 engine, perfect for the car.
Yeah.
This needs to be rebuilt.
Oh, hang on. I'll tell you what. I'll just put my hand in our endless pocket and just find another engine. This is more than a rebuild, right? I tell you, this ain't get on.
Next day at the garage, Mario and Mike get their first look underneath the car.
Wow.
Yeah. The rockers are shut. They've been tack welded here, but they're shut. They can go around in circles. Rust.
There's an unpleasant surprise.
I'm gonna have to definitely replace this section in here.
This is insane. My whole hand is in the frame of the car. The subframe
on the right side of the carb, which supports the whole convertible top mechanism, is completely rusted right through almost to the other side. If this collapses, someone could get seriously hurt. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this, Bernie.
Better you than me.
You know what? Go make a list of what else you think we need, and I'll deal with Bernie.
Okay.
Bernie!
Yes, you summon me, Your Honor. What can I do for you? Ooh, sugar.
Take a breath.
That's gonna be a big job, Mario. A very, very big job.
Look at this. I think I can put my hand through the other side, I'm not sure.
It's a major setback.
And we got this other section over here.
It's bad, Mario. It's like rusted badly.
And over here, which is still flimsy, and we have to support it and weld it.
Holes everywhere in the floor.
I'm pissed.
First, all the rusted metal is cut out from the car. Then a plasma cutter is used to form steel patches. The temperature of the cutter's gas is an astonishing 16,000 degrees Celsius, hotter than the surface of the sun. It slices through metal. Each piece of metal needs to be machined to fit the body precisely. Then it's bolted to the frame and welded into final position. Next, the mechanics need to repair and install the missing floor pan. To prepare it for welding, Sonia uses an orbital grinder to strip off primer, exposing bare metal so that it can be welded too. The floor pan is tack welded into place. Mike uses a hammer to beat the floor pan into shape.
Wow.
Morning, Mike.
Morning.
Look at these subframes here. Oh, this looks really good, man. This is like right out of the factory.
This is all new. This is all new piece, a new piece welded in here, a new piece welded in here. Then they put a factory rubber seal on.
This round here was completely rotten. I'll tell you something, it's solid. I don't give my hand to anyone, but I'll tell you something, you've made a damn good job of that, man.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Mike, let's get it down.
Oh! Ah! Oh, Mario, for sake! What is the matter with you? Wait a minute, shut up! Look what the you done!
You think I wanted to drop the stupid thing? I picked it up like this in an angle. You're supposed to wear gloves. And I cut my finger. I started bleeding, I just dropped it.
For a couple of seconds, I could have put a hammer on his head.